Hello, everybody. It's J. Rowe. We're going to be making the Chess 960 video tonight. Just wanted to get a video out this week here. It's been really, really busy, and I was going to continue on with my middle game study, but we'll have to do that another time. So I'm going to be looking for a Chess 960 game, someone over 1800, hopefully. And actually, maybe I'll just seek one. Okay, hold on a second. Chess 960. And let's go with the 5 minute game. And I'll just put a little wager on it here so we get somebody quick. Rating range, what is this here? So I'll take up to 1813 to 2333. Okay, so let's do this one. So seek. Should pop up on the graph here. It's been a while since I made a video on Chess Cube. They've done actually some improvements to the site. It's not too bad. I played a little bit of Bullet here. I don't know, the way the pieces move in Bullet's a little bit different than what I'm used to in terms of the sounds and the animations and stuff, but it was all right. So where's mine here? Okay, I'm just making sure it's rated here. So I'll keep my eye out for some triangles here. Those are the 960 games. 1 minute chess 960. I'm not that good at 960. Might throw a bullet or two into the end of this video too. We'll have to see. This is just kind of a blitz down video. So we're still waiting. I might need to lower my seek parameters or something. I usually like to do at or above rating. Well, actually, I always do at or above rating for the videos. So it's my preference. So yeah, summer's kind of winding down here. We're halfway through it, and you know what? If you guys want to put in the comments, I'm debating between doing some more middle game study. I'm also debating on doing another opening, and I'm also debating on doing what was that other one I wanted to do? I found another little trap line that I wanted to cover in a video too. So whatever you guys prefer, just put it down in the comments below. And that's about a quick update on what I'm looking at working on. We got the Olympiad taking place here in Norway, which I'm going to be following, and I'm not sure if I'll do any videos on it, but if something comes up really nice tactical wise or a brilliant game, I might put that up there. But I did select my team for the fantasy chess, so I got that all ready to go. Hopefully I'll win. It's called Chessgasm Express. Maybe that's what I'll call this video. That's my name. Apparently, they have a prize for the name, but you guys know me and Chessgasm if you've been subscribed to me for a long time. This little term came up with a few years back. A number of years now, actually. All right, so we're not getting any action here whatsoever for 960, and I don't feel like waiting forever. So I'm going to lower my parameters here to 1750 to 2333. Chess 960, good. And, or you know what I could do? Hold on a second. Let me put this back up to 1800 ish, and let's just make it free. Maybe someone will grab that if it's free. And if this doesn't work in 15 seconds, then I'm gonna just change it from rated to unrated. And how can you go wrong with that? So there we go, 1833. And I could just pop in on one of these regular games, but I'm gonna wait. Okay, cancel, and let's go unrated. Come on, somebody. Somebody pop on. 5 minute chess 960. Fisher Random. Oh, I got my books in the mail today. Lost all my chess books in the flood. I'm really excited. One of them was Garry Kasparov's most or not most memorable. Garry Kasparov's My Great Predecessors, Volume 1. So I'm really excited about that to get into that book and take a look at it. I've heard so many great things about it, and got a couple other books that I used to have as well. Unfortunately, I lost my first edition Bobby Fischer book, My Most Memorable Games. It was a first edition hardcover, and haven't been able to find a replacement for it yet. I got that video on that about that. You know what? I might just jump in on a bullet game here because I'm tired of talking without doing anything. Let's see here. So we'll keep an eye on this side of the board here. Okay, 1821 bullet. Let's do it. And I'm going to go with King's Indian. I don't care what he plays. Let's just do this. We'll get our castle on here. And I'm going to do a little bit of this. Just because I can thrust here to see if I want to take. Let's see what he takes. Okay, so I'm going to get my rook on that file. And I don't need to worry about that bishop right now. But I can do this. What's up? What are you going to do? Let's do this. Take the pawn. You want to take the pawn? You can't. And let's do... He's got two attackers on the pawn now. Okay, gotta move. Let's vacate that whole idea. Gotta watch out for tricks here. Sure. He should have pinned it with his rook. That would have been a little bit better. Okay, gotta move a little quick now. Just gonna take that. There we go. Go ahead. Pretend to attack something for the short term. Oh no, I just dropped the knight. Oh, you didn't see it. I'll take that though. Let's defend that. Let's take that. Get the check. Why not? Bring the rook down. Get it safe. Okay, I'll take that. Let's do this. Just hit the check for the fun of it. Just trying to eat up a little bit of clock time here. Keep my peace. Boom, what's up? What's up? Pawn. With check. Pre-move warrior, man. Take that. Oh, he should have took my rook. He should have took it. He's going to go on time. There we go. Alright. Well, he was pretty close rating, so let's get back out there. Since it was bullet, I'm just going to click on play so we can pick the game we want, just in case a 960 pops up. And yeah, let me know if you guys want more bullet videos, because I really enjoy playing bullet chess. I'm actually trying out a chess site right now. It's called Velocity Chess, and it's in beta. And I got a heads up on it from a person on Twitter whom I respect from their tweets. And, you know, the bullet on there is actually pretty good. It's still in beta, so there's hardly, you know, there's not a great number of people that are playing on there. But it's I'm going to be making a video of it just to show you guys what it's all about, kind of like what I did with Fly Chess. And but I really like the way that the pieces move in bullet and the animations and stuff. And apparently, the person who's creating the site is, they're even refining that even further, so the bullet's going to be even better. So I'm pretty excited about that. But yeah, I like playing bullet. I don't usually put up bullet videos. Historically, I haven't been that great at bullet. But I've had some victories recently against 2,000 plus rated players in bullet. So it's something that I like to do once in a while. I don't know. If you guys are really comfortable with bullet, let me know. But I noticed that after I play bullet for like an evening or something, my longer time control suffers. So if you guys have any pro tips on how to avoid that or whatever, just let me know. I've been doing a little bit more tactics and such. I don't know if this is the same guy that we played last time, 1813. So I'm going to skip past that one. Keep an eye out for a triangle here. What's this one here? 1838. Okay, it's too slow to click that one. We'll see what we got here. That's a little low. Let's see. One thing I don't understand about Chess Cube is I have premium, but it keeps advertising premium for me. Don't understand that. Okay, so we're not seeing a lot of action here. Maybe I should just put my seek up anyway. Is it still 960? Okay, I'll put my seek up and we'll keep an eye over here. Okay, 1843. Let's do this one. That's a bullet game. And oh, I got black again. Wow, lucky me. I was kind of hoping for a white so I can use the pincer attack, but This is kind of like the pincer. It's a hedgehog. I'm gonna do a little differently though. Yeah, I'm just gonna contest right into the center. Whatever, man, let's do it. What are you gonna do? Are you gonna push your pawn? So he's bringing in some action here, so I'm going to do that to open up some access for my hopefully queen. I can just push here, right? Got the rook supporting that. Okay, I'll just sack the rook, whatever. I don't want to mess around with any kind of trouble here. He can take that with his pawn, and I will retake with my bishop. And I get my queen on here. And oh, I think he just dropped his queen, didn't he? Yes, he did. And his knight. Too bad. Let's retreat that queen. Let's attack the rook. Oh, I just dropped my queen in return. Oh, he missed it. Fortunate. Let's attack the pawn. Take the pawn. Take that pawn. Go here. Back down here. Attack the bishop. Take that. Drop my queen again. Gotta love bullet. He missed it again. I'm so whatever, man. I'm just taking it. Okay, I'm gonna take this rook. I'm more concerned about time than I am anything else. I'm gonna put my rook right here. Do that. Put it back here. It's looking pretty good here. Okay, just take that. Hit the check. Hit the check. Hit the check. Okay, let's do this. Oh, he didn't take it. Oh, is he trying to get a stalemate on me? Maybe. Oh no, what happened? What happened? Game. Oh, maybe I ran out of time. Oh, good for him. Okay. Oh, I should have taken the rematch there. I was just thinking about it. Okay. So let's give up on the 960 thing, and we're going to play one more bullet. So best out of three. So we've got a draw, sort of, and we've got a win. And maybe this time we'll get white, because I've had black 2 times in a row, so we'll bust out the pincer attack. For new subscribers, we worked on creating a new opening called the pincer attack a number of years ago. You can actually find it on my channel. It's in a playlist called the pincer attack, and it is a great bullet tool. Like, I mean, after I posted the video, King's Crusher tried it. Back then when I first posted it, I was quite new at chess, a couple years into chess, and King Crusher beat a grandmaster. And recently, I haven't played Bullet for a long time, but recently I picked it up again and I beat a couple players over 2,000 with it. It's really good for a couple of reasons. Number one, it's got a lot of moves in the beginning that you can pretty reasonably play with a good amount of frequency. So you get a lot of moves, so you get a nice clock edge. And as well, it gives you the versatility to kind of punch into either side of the board. So it's like a pincer attack from the military strategy, where you're coming from both sides, but also a little bit into the middle as well. So you can check that out when you get some time. Fazdam, 1838. Okay, I'll do this one. Give me white. Give me white. Not sure what flag that is. I got black again. All right, let's see what he plays here. King's pawn. Okay, set up here. Okay, you can take that. I'm gonna take my queen probably. Gonna put this light square bishop here. And I need to get my king out of there. And I've got some problems, not gonna lie. But that actually kind of helps. Okay, so he's gonna come down there. Let's just kick it out. And let's play the knight over here. Okay, gotta get a little better with. Actually, I don't want to take with that. Darn it. Okay, I can do this. I don't think I can do that. I have to do this. And then I gotta do. Okay, I see something possible here. I'm not sure if he'll fall for it. Actually, it's not. It's nothing special, to be honest. But whatever. I'll attack this rook with the pawn. See if he just pushes there or not. Thank goodness for my light square bishop, right? Okay, I'll just. Oh, what's going on, man? Dude. I'll take that rook drop. Oh, I just dropped my bishop. Like a boss. Okay, this light square bishop's gonna be a trouble for me here. So now it's not though. There we go. Okay, so he forfeited on time. We'll see if he wants a rematch. If he takes a rematch, then I'll probably get white. Yay! Okay, pincer attack time. So just watch this here. So really, the only thing you got to be careful of in the beginning is sometimes they'll capture a little bit earlier than usual. But if someone fianchettos on the same diagonal as you, then it can be trouble if you pre-move it. So just a warning, if you pre-move it, it could be trouble. So you got to watch out for that. I've been caught on that a couple times just because I'm really trying to, get something going with the clock or whatever. I'm going to try to open up the center a little bit here and just close it up on this side. And I got to get a better square for my knight. So I'm actually going to take that. And then I'll do this, and then we can trade queens. And I can drop my bishop. Happy times, good times, good times. It's going to take my queen now. Okay, let's do that. Least now I can kind of be pesky and take some pawns. All that fun stuff. Trying to get a little bit of. Let's kick that. I got back row mate. What am I doing? Good game. Man, I feel like playing one more, but a different opponent. Let's see here. One more bullet. And then we'll call the video. Oh my gosh, no, I'm not good enough. I'm not good enough for bullet 960. There's no way. I don't think so. That's a 1 plus 1, so it's not as quick, but I'm just not that quick at 960 yet at all. I play it once in a while for fun, but I don't actually like focus on it and play a lot of games on it. I think I played like maybe 10 960 games in the last 4 or 5 months. At least since May, anyway. But a bullet should pop up here pretty quick. Okay, that's too big of a bet, otherwise I'd take it. I'm always leery of those 550 bets when I see them on the site, because I don't know. What's this here? That's chess 960 again. It's 1 plus 1. Should be something popping up here quick. Oh, that's a little too low. 2296 TCF Havoc. That is definitely a King Crusher opponent, not a J. Roby Chess opponent. I've only been playing for like a minuscule amount of time compared to Crusher. 2003, let's do it. Let's see. Oh, I got the pincer attack. Let's see if we can make it work. Let's see if he knows what's coming. Doesn't look like it. Right, what side do I want to thrust on? I think I'm going to thrust on this one. See, you can do this on both sides, right? So it's very flexible that way. And then you just kind of counterpunch. Okay, I'm not going to do that. Like this, right? And then all of a sudden you're really annoying. I haven't castled yet. I should probably do that. Can I get away with that? I think so. And I'm not going to fall for that trick. I'll pre-move that just in case he wants to. Okay, let's do this. Do this. Do this. Take that. Get back. What are you going to push, buddy? Which pawn are you going to push? Got some problems here. I think I'm sort of getting there on clock, but I'm not positive. You want to trade? Okay, let's trade down. Okay, good. What's up? You gotta worry about some pawns, my friend. King's gonna be too slow. Now I gotta get a mate, though. No! Oh no! Misclicked it, man. Oh my gosh. Oh well. We could have had that game. We were close, man. We had a huge clock advantage. But now you've seen what the pincer attack can do. So try it out. Let me know what you think. And we will see you next video.